history of Earth. In this video explained by the history of Earth, the national history of Earth concerns the development of planet Earth from its formulation to the present day. Nearly all branches of national sciences have contributed to understanding of the main events of Earth past characteristics by constant geological change and biological evolution. The geological time scale is defined by the national convention as the large spans of time from the beginning from the Earth to the present. From around 4.54 billion years ago, approximately 1/3 the age of the universe by its ratio from the solar nebula. What kind of place in the very created the primary atmosphere and then the ocean, but the early atmosphere contained almost no oxygen. Much of the Earth was molten because of frequent collision with other bodies, which led to a strange volcanic have been suggested that double-walled bubbles of lipid like those that form the Earth on life, and the nations to the subcontinents of the Leapord external membranes of cells have may been a central first step experiment that simulated the condition of the early Earth formed reported formation of lipids. And now in this can spontaneously formed liposized double-walled bubbles and then reproduce themselves, although they are not intrinsically information carriers as nucleic acids are, they would be subject to natural selection of longevity and reproductions. Nucleic acids such as RNA might then have formed more easily within the liposomes and they have would have outside. The clay theory of part of Earth in the history of Earth. Some clays, notably morinolite, have properties that make them plausible accelerators for the emergence of an RNA world. They grow by self-replication by their crystalline pattern, are subject to an analog of natural selection as a clay of species that grows fastest in a particular environment rapidly becomes dominant and can catalyze the formation of RNA molecules. Although this idea has not become the scientific convention, it still has active supporters. And now, information by the last universal common ancestors of Proterozoic Eon. The Proterozoic Eon lasted from 2.5 Ga to 538 Ma million years ago. In the time span, cratons grew into continents with modern size. The change to an oxygen-rich atmosphere, which a critical development, life developed from prokaryotes into eukaryotes and multicellular forms, The protozoic saw a couple of several ice nations call to the subcontinents, and now information by the United States of America of Earth ascended at about 5 and 18 May. The Edicarine Vita formed the periolate from the Cambrian explorations. And now the part of oxygen revolutions. The earliest cells about to absorb energy and food from the surrounding environment. They used fermentation, the breakdown of more complex compound into less complex compound with less energy, and use the energy so liberated to grow and reproduce. Fermentation and can only occur in an aerobic oxygen-free environment. The evolution of photosynthesis made it possible for cells to derive energy from the sun. Most of the life that covered the surface of the earth depend directly or indirectly on the photosynthesis. The most common form, oxygen photosynthesis, turns carbon dioxide, water, and sunlight into food. It captures the energy of sunlight in energy-rich molecules such as ATP, which then provide the energy to make sugar to supply the electrons in the circuit. Hydrogen stripped from water, leaving oxygen as a waste product. Some organisms, including purple bacteria and green sulfur bacteria, use any oxygen from make of photosynthesis that uses alternatives through hydrogen stripped from water as electron donor. Example as hydrogen sulfide, sulfur, and iron. Such extremophile organisms are restricted to otherwise inhospitable environments such as large springs and hypothermal vents. The simpler any oxygenated from air was about 3.8 GA, not long after the appearance of life. The timing of oxygen photosynthesis is more controversial. It had certainly appeared by about 2.4 GA, but some researchers put it back as far as 3.2 GA. The latter probably increased global productivity of other orders of magnitude. And now, at first, the released oxygen was found by the limestone, iron, and other minerals. The oxidized iron appears as red layers in geological strata called banded iron formation that form in the abundance during the Siderite period between 2500 Ma and 2300 Ma, when the most of the exposed readily reacting minerals where oxidized oxygen finally began to accumulate in the atmosphere. Thus, each cell only produced a minute amount of oxygen. The combined metabolism of many cells over a last time of formed Earth atmosphere to its current state, the waste Earth third atmosphere. The third and similar oxygenating form arose about 3.8 GA, not long after the appearance of life. The timing of oxygen photosynthesis is more controversial. If had continually and certainly appeared by about 2.4 GA, but some researchers put it back as far as 3.2 GA. The latter probably increased global productivity by at least 2 or 3 orders of magnitude. Among the oldest remnants of oxygen producing life forms and fossil stromatolites. And some oxygen was stimulated by ultra and solar violet radiation to form ozone, which collected in a layer near the upper part of the atmosphere. The ozone layer absorbed and still absorbs a significant amount of the ultraviolet radiation that once at passed through the atmosphere. It allowed cells to colonize the surface of the ocean and eventually the land. Without the ozone layer, ultraviolet radiation bombarding land and sea wall have caused unsustainable levels of mutation in exposed cells. Photosynthesis had another major impact. Oxygen was toxic. Much life on Earth probably died out as it level rose in what is known as the oxygen catastrophe. Resident forms survived and some developed into ability to use oxygen to increase their metabolism and obtain from energy from the same food. And now, in the time of snowball, Earth is a part of history of Earth and information by the natural evolution of the Sun made it progressively more luminous during the Archean and Protozoic eons. The Sun's luminosity increases 60 degrees every billion years. As a result, the Earth began to receive more heat from the Sun in the Proterozoic eon. However, the Earth did not warm. Instead, the geological record suggested it cooled dramatically during the early Protozoic glacial deposit found in South Africa, dated back to 2.2 GA, at which time, based on paleomagnetic evidence, that must have been located near the equator. Thus, these glaciers, known as the Permian glaciers, may have been global. Some scientists suggest this way observed that the Earth was frozen away from the poles to the equator, a hypothesis called snowball Earth. The Hadrian Ice Age might have been caused by the increased oxygen concentration in the atmosphere, which caused the decrease of methane CH4 in the atmosphere. Methane is a strong greenhouse gas, but with oxygen it reacts to form CO2, a less effective greenhouse gas. When free oxygen becomes available in the atmosphere, the concentration of methane could have decreased dramatically enough to counter the effect of the increasing heat flow from the Sun. However, the term snowball Earth is more commonly used to describe later extreme ice age during the Cryogenic period. So guys, in this video are very long, but the information by very hard and very strong in very your periods on all life, each lasting about 10 million years between 750 and 580 million years ago, when Earth is thought to have been covered with an ice part of from the highest mountains. The average temperature were about 50 centigrades. The snowball may have been partly due to the location of the supercontinent Rodinia. Starting the equator, carbon dioxide combined with rain to weather rocks to form carbonic acid, which is washed out to sea, thus extracting the greenhouse gas from the atmosphere. When the continents and near the poles, the advance of ice covers and the rocks, slowing the reduction in carbon dioxide. But in the Cryogenic, the weathering of Rodinia was able to continue unchecked until the ice advanced to the tropics. The process may have finally been reversed by the emissions of carbon dioxide from volcanoes or the destabilization of methane gas hydrates. According to the alternative slushball Earth theory, even at the height of the ice age, there was still open water at the equator.